This is Cumberland Lake, located just an hour and a half outside Salt Lake City. It's a beautiful spot that's perfect for hiking, fishing, and camping. But interestingly, it's also at the heart of one of Utah's most puzzling unsolved missing persons cases. This is 12-year-old Garrett Bardsley. Born and raised in Elk River, Utah, Garrett and his brothers grew up enjoying the outdoors. At a young age, Garrett had joined the Boy Scouts and was a part of Troop 694, based out of nearby Provo, Utah. On August 19th, 2004, a group of 18 Boy Scouts accompanied by 6 to 7 adults, including both Garrett and his father, Kevin Bardsley, made their way out to the Uintah Wasatch National Forest, planning on spending the weekend camping on the shores of Cumberland Lake. The campers spent the day hiking out to the location and setting up their campsite. After a successful first evening in the mountains, the scouts ate their dinner, roasted some marshmallows, and prepared for bed. This is when Garrett and his father made plans to get up earlier than everyone else the following morning and try their luck with some fishing at the nearby lake. Waking up earlier than the other campers, Garrett and Kevin headed to the lake with the hopes of catching some fish. Unfortunately, while at the lakeside, Garrett had accidentally fell in, soaking his shoes, socks, and pants. Feeling very uncomfortable in his now soaking wet clothes, he had asked his dad if he could go back to the camp and change. The campsite was only about 150 yards away, with a very well-established trail leading straight to the campsite. Since they had walked the trail several times before and were very familiar with the area, Kevin felt comfortable letting Garrett walk back to camp alone. Garrett excitedly told his father he would return soon and promised that when he returned, he would land his dad a fish for breakfast. Garrett hurried off towards the trail to camp, and Kevin kept a close eye on him all the way until he entered the woodline and was no longer in sight. After about 20 minutes, Garrett had not returned, and Kevin grew worried. He decided to head back to camp to investigate. To his dismay, he found that Garrett had never made it back to the camp, and no one else had seen or knew of his whereabouts. Kevin's worst fear had become a reality, as his son had seemingly vanished without a trace. The alarm was raised, and a massive search and rescue operation went into action for Garrett. Given his young age and vulnerability, and the fact that he had minimal gear and was carrying only a fishing pole, authorities initiated a large-scale effort. They quickly established a 3-square-mile search zone, and over 200 team members and volunteers quickly arrived to the area and began searching in full force. Yet as the day turned into night, no sign of Garrett was found. No footprints were found in the dirt, no dropped items recovered, and strangest of all, the search dogs were unable to pick up a scent trail of any kind. To make matters worse, the weather began to suddenly change, and by the evening of August 20th, it began to rain, with temperatures dropping to near freezing, making hypothermia a major concern for everybody. The next day, a discovery was made that would confuse investigators and later go on to define this case in the world of unsolved missing persons cases. A single black Nike sock, soaked in water and wadded into a ball, was found in a boulder field around half a mile away from where Garrett originally went missing. Family of Garrett's claimed it was an exact match to the ones Garrett had at home and was wearing that day. While later on, a search volunteer would claim to have lost a sock while changing out of his wet socks in the field. It was never determined who the sock belonged to, but to this day, family of Garrett swear it belonged to him. But even stranger, the one item Garrett had in his possession, a small fishing pole, was never recovered, hinting at whatever happened in those mountains to Garrett, his fishing pole met a similar fate. The search went on for 9 days until the snow came and forced the search and rescue operation to a halt. At this point, Garrett's fate was sealed, and to this day, almost 2 decades later, his remains have yet to be recovered. So what happened to Garrett? Many theories circulate the internet on this topic, yet each one seems about as unlikely as the last. The first theory involves some sort of animal attack. Northern Utah is home to many animals, including bears and mountain lions, that could easily take down a 12-year-old boy. Yet, no blood, drag marks, ripped clothing, tracks, or signs of a struggle were ever found. Given his close proximity to his dad at the lake and other campers at the campsite, somebody would have heard him yell or scream if such a thing occurred. On top of all that, professional search and rescue teams were involved, and they were trained to look for scavenger birds circling the sky, which would lead them to any remains of an attacked or eaten person. Yet, none of these things were found. The other popular theory is that Garrett was kidnapped. The trail out to the lake is 3.5 miles long and covers quite a bit of rough terrain. When I hiked out to the location to investigate this case, the trail had quite a bit of foot traffic, passing by several dozen people on my way in and out. The chances somebody could abduct and carry the 12-year-old at 5 foot tall and 105 pounds out of the forest without a passing hiker noticing is extremely unlikely. Also, in the case of abduction, Garrett would have most definitely dropped his fishing pole at some point, leaving clues behind as to what may have happened to him. The authorities said the case had no evidence of foul play, and suspected the boy got lost, climbed into a small cave or outcropping, eventually succumbing to hypothermia. Yet, after nearly 20 years of searching the forest, in both official and unofficial searches, nobody has yet to find any human remains. The strangest part about this case, by far, is that it's in no way unique. The forests of North America have had hundreds of similar cases of people disappearing without a trace, leaving behind a trail of broken families and unanswered questions. So one unanswered question remains. What is really going on in our national parks and forests?